Welcome to my art studio. I'm Harshi Like the Chocolates, and today in this video, we're going to learn how to paint Pluto in three different ways. And through this process, learn to transition from pop art to realism. You will also see the subtle difference outline and edges can make to a painting. Finally, since in this painting I'm using Heaney watercolor paints, this is also a watercolor painting tutorial. So without further ado, let's start painting.
I will be creating my paintings on separate sheets of paper, but you can do that on a single sheet as well. These are 200 GSM watercolor sheets, and I took them out of my perfect art journal. I will add links to all of my supplies in my description. I always secure my pages with washi tape so they don't move, and also they don't curl up while I am using watercolors. To begin my process, I'm going to start with identical sketches. Now, artist tip number one, the sketches have to be made with a very sharp pencil. Also, your pencil impressions need to be very, very light. Otherwise, those impressions will be a big pain to erase later. Remember, the pencil marks are only your guideline. Proportion and positioning is very important in a painting, for which we should always start with a small grid, starting with a few lines to indicate the top of the head of Pluto and the bottom of his feet. Then create an 8x2 grid in between these two lines. Now, using this as my reference, I am transferring Pluto onto each page. You can pause the video at this moment and transfer Pluto to all of your pages as well. Leave comments below if you would like me to make a video on how to use the grid method to transfer images. Now that we are done with sketching, we can move on to paint one Pluto at a time. Starting with our first art style, the basic pop art. These paintings feature block colors, black outlines, and no shadows. Before we start painting, don't forget to use a kneadable eraser to further lighten up your sketch and to also remove the grid lines. Along with watercolors, you will also need a palette and painting water. This style of painting is like painting with numbers without any numbers. You choose your color and you keep blocking one shape at a time. So ideally, you go from the lightest color towards the darker color. Say, I'm doing the skin color first, then I might do orange, then I might do blue. And the black will be at the very last. Now we do this because it's easy to paint dark color on light, but the other way around, not so much. You might also have seen in my painting that when I'm painting any shape, I'm doing an outline with that color around the shape first, and then I'm painting inside of it. And it is also very important when you are using the watercolor, do not go over the surface you have already painted again and again. Just make the mark and move on. Revisiting the same surface again and again will make your brush pick off the color instead of putting it on, if that makes sense. And finally, for watercolors, you do not need a lot of brush. You just need one medium-sized round brush, and maybe for outlines, a small detailing brush. But that's it. Now, when you are doing outlines, it's very important to keep adding water to your paint and prep it before you put it on the canvas. With watercolors, it is also very important to let the base color dry before you add the outlines, otherwise your colors will bleed through like mine is doing right now. Also, you have to hold your brush like a pencil or a pen, not like a wand, and apply almost zero pressure to create those beautiful and straight lines. I often even hold my breath when I'm doing the outlines. That also stabilizes my hand a little bit and ensures that I make those beautiful smooth lines. And with that, our first pop art Pluto is complete. The second style is still going to be pop art, but a bit closer to the realism. We are still going to have block colors and outlines, but it will be colorful and there would be introduction of shadows and highlights. For this style of painting, I've already done the base layer of the colors, which are very similar to our first painting. The only change is the colors are a little bit more watered down. Once your base layer is ready and dry, we will start to introduce some shadows. For shadows, you have to choose either left or right side. And with colors just slightly darker than the colors you have already used, create random but almost parallel patches of shadows. Add shadows to every closed shape, and remember that here a small stroke really goes a long way. Don't forget to add shadows to the white parts like teeth and hands. These shadows will give a nice depth to your painting without taking away the pop art part of it. And once you're happy with your shadows, you will start to add the outlines. But this time, instead of using black colors, we will be using colors a shade darker than what we have already used. For instance, around orange color, I am using brown outlines. The only rule you need to follow is the outlines have to be darker than the shadows. And around your shapes with white color, you can use blue color outline, a very light blue color. So keep it nice and simple, shadows darker than base color and outline darker than the shadows. And with that, our second style is complete. Now last and final style is realistic painting. Here we will completely remove all the outlines and replace them with edges. The colors are going to be more blended and you will see a lot of shadows and highlights. This style is a very detail oriented, and if this is your first time, I highly recommend using a reference. Work on one small part at a time and pay key attention to how the colors change. For example, Pluto's eyes look white, but they actually have different shades of gray in it. So this is what you're going to do. You will find a mid-tone, a highlight, and a shadow. And this you will repeat with every single color and every single part of Pluto. In some part there might be just two colors, and in some there might be more. Your task is to identify those subtle changes and work on one single object at a time. When you're working on larger areas like his shirt, you can add a base color and then keep layering the darker colors one at a time. And make sure to let the colors dry before layering them up. Keep referring back to the image to identify the shadows and even deeper shadows. And if you lack patience like me, you can even use a dryer to dry the layers in between. The easiest way to go about watercolors is use your highlight color and make a base layer of it, then keep adding shadows on top of it and leaving the highlight bare so they can retain their bright light color, and work on just one object at a time. With this, we are done with our third and final style of Pluto. Each style has its own appeal, drawbacks, and advantages. They are certainly not better than each other, but it is all about the preference. Only you can choose if you want to paint like Da Vinci, Dali, or Andy Warhol. Or if you are like me, why choose? You can create all three of them. Leave in the comments which Pluto is your favorite, and thank you for tuning in. I hope you learned something from this video, and don't forget to enjoy the process.